Okay, so it kind of starts out. It uses arpeggio a lot. Let's just play it. Let's just play a G scale arpeggio.
Is there any decided thinking on whether the high part is first or the low part?
I know around here everybody plays the low part first, don't they?
They do.
And I don't know what it is in Christeson's book. Maybe that's where I get which part is I play
remember.
High. But down, I always consider the high part first,
okay.
But it doesn't matter, you know.
No, it doesn't.
But yeah, everybody around here I know plays the low part first. So let's just play a G arpeggio, and that's going to be all the G's, B's, and D's from here all the way up to here, because this tune uses the arpeggio a lot here. So here we go. Red, about two beats on each note. Okay, good. So the first little bit of the tune is kind of like this. Okay, so it starts on this B note here. And go. One more time on that. We'll go through it kind of faster. We'll dig in a little deeper on the other ones, but since several people know this, we'll just go through it kind of quicker. Enough talking, right? And then kind of a little. So that's all on the E string. Except one note, which is on the A string. Up on here in this A. I'm going to give you a gross generalization, but a lot of these this is kind of what I'd call more of a rhythmic tune than a melodic tune, you know? And a lot of these kind of rhythmic tunes, especially in G, for some reason, harmonically, they like to leave out the second finger, you know? There's a lot of licks where you do. It's kind of something to keep in mind when you hear those kind of tunes. There's a ton of tunes that kind of leave out that little bit. Okay, here we go. So start right here. Here we go. Ready, go. Sort of similar kind of idea on this happening on the second part is not using the second finger much. So. And then a whole passage, no second finger. So it's all on the A and D string, kind of like, listen one time. Let's play that. One more time. Once more with feeling. And then that's a lick that, again, no second finger. Start on the D. One more time. What you got so far sounds kind of like this. Drop down to the B on the G string. So that's like a scale from B to D, B to G, leaving out the E, leaving out the first finger. So it's. One more time. then here's kind of, again, more of a rhythmic than melodic lick, kind of. End up on the open D. Let me just play you the second part now, just listen one time. Is this. Okay, so let's just play that second part together. Kind of slow. Here we go. Ready, play. Pretty much with saw bowing most of the way. Might be a slur or two in there. So let me play you the whole tune one more time, and then we'll just noodle around on it a little bit. Okay? All right, the whole tune's here we go. Play with this, Patty. I'm not gonna play it too fast. Let's play it through a couple times and then I'll go on to another tune. Just trying to give you a little taste of this one. It's and I'll send you the dots for it, of course, too. Here we go. High part first. just keep in mind, like, that's on these rhythmic sort of tunes. I don't know why, but in G, that's like leaving out that second finger on those licks. And one other thing to watch when you're playing this tune is, well, since I play the first part, that the high part first, you know, you've got the held quarter notes. If you start that out too fast and you get to this part, suddenly you're like, you're overloaded, you know. Oh, I can't play that part that fast. So it's just something to keep in mind there.